every snap. You know there will be people in your life, they are killing you. They are the snake. And they will be smiling with you at the same time. Praise Jesus. If those people are in your life, they do damage to your life. If they are in your business, they do damage to your business. If they are in your ministry, they do damage. So in God, you have to pray that God should open your eye to see those kind of people. So look at it. If snake is hiding there, you are playing, you might be playing with it. People lie down in the grass. You can lie, you be lying with your snake that is killing you. You might be sleeping with the snake that is killing you. You might be kissing the snake that is killing you. You might be romancing the snake that is killing you. So but God will expose every snake in your life in the name of Jesus. God will expose them in the name of Jesus. So I go to the war. A man who understands warfare in the Bible, I respect David so much. That is why God says a man of my own heart. The man understand warfare. He did all his life of ministry. All war, was a man of war. Praise Jesus. That's why God says a man of my own heart. Can you open on the book of Psalm 55, quickly, verse 12. Read quickly. Psalm 55, verse 12.
For it was not an enemy that reproached me. Psalm 55, verse 12. For it was not an enemy that reproached me.
Look at the David was saying that it was not an enemy outside that was fighting him. Jesus said one statement that many Christians have not really understand. They can't comprehend it. Jesus said a man's enemy is a member of your household. As we are here right now, nobody knows whether I stand on top of this grass or let they show it on television next month. Isn't it?
Yeah.
But if somebody is out here that one time, people, as I said, and if you want to pass on it and do today, he puts snake under the grass, stand on top of it. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So a man's enemy is a member of his household. As you are, Jesus has made that comment. If your enemy can't get to you, they have to look for household a member to join them. And if they have not found household member will find them. What? If people will say, I will run, which is worrying me from Africa. People are worrying me from Africa. I want to run to Europe. So that, let me tell you, let me not tell you, being too fat. The witches in Europe are more dangerous than one in Africa. Because they wear coat. Praise Jesus. When God takes you to Fofu, in the city of Mammon, you know that it's not the same story. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
If they are looking for you, they will transfer to Kesla. So the witches in Sweden. So when they transfer it, then the person before your friend will be their friend. They will, because you become, if they become so nice, and you say, oh, this is my friend, very good. I just met him in Sweden. He's a very nice man. But la la, he's an agent, praise God.
Yeah.
He'll be doing you good for the first time. He'll be collecting information about you to go and give to them. You will say, I just met a friend in Sweden. He's my good friend, praise God. But it's a green snake under the green grass. He's trying to give all information to the enemy. So don't be trying to say, oh, I run Africa. I run to Africa. I run from Africa to Oklahoma. Yeah, yeah, I'm more wicked. They are more wicked, praise Jesus. Don't be deceived by those ones. So one thing, it is only when the house enemy does not involve, nobody can get you. Let me tell you, if all the people in Sweden is fighting me, they can't get me. It is somebody in my family, in my household, that will tell them I can help you to get it. Praise Jesus. And if witches in Mammon they are looking for me, they can't find me. It is a member of the church they will look for that will give them information. So many pastors have not comprehend this. Many leaders have not understand this. They are still playing religion. Religion can't save anybody. All you can do is what happened inside this church yesterday. Yeah, this is one of the two of them did dedication. If what happened inside this church yesterday, if you have ordinary day, many of you will be lying there for 2 hours, 3 hours, you will not get up. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. There was no instrument. Sometimes many of you have been so soaked in instrument. Without music did not play, you don't get to the presence of God. The press worship were here, they left. When the people came, when the power of God was in this place, hit this place. All the you to see the Jesus standing in front of the altar, ordinary stranger. Not one to praise Jesus. So you have to understand. It's only our hand. We just clap our hands and sing. And God hold not a praise from the heart. Not from the lips. That's why I say they honor me with their lips, but the heart is different. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. So David was a man of war. And he made a statement. He began to make a statement. What made David to be making this statement? Read, my brother, quickly. I want to understand. Don't be deceived by people. Don't be moved by people. I'm not moved by people. If Jesus said, oh, today, I'm not going to church. I will never bother you. Praise Jesus. As he's leaving, God will bring another one. That is the God we serve. Praise God. Whether it's what I don't build my ministry on people. That is what we say people have not understand. Just one person will preach the message. You know why? My spiritual father has taught us in the school of ministry. Kenneth Hagin. He said before he died, and I don't know, I was going to honor him all the days of because I got to see all the wisdom he teach us. I need to see in the present day church today. He said, you know what? He said, go into the world and preach the word. He said, but in the world, there is disco, there is oratory, people that can speak, use eloquent word to deceive people. He said, but I want you to go and preach the word of God. When you present, you preach the word of God will make a difference. He said, but in the beginning, in the ministry of the word of God, there's going to be a lot of fight. But at the end, people will find the truth. Amen. Praise Jesus. So, I stick to that, and he made another statement, which is in my diary. I mean, once in a month, I want to do diary to remind myself. He said, what is, you know, if you are in a church, everybody in the church, leave that church. He said, still carry your the Bible, go to your kitchen, print the message, put it into YouTube or any place, and people will still hear it. If it's radio, go to radio and preach the truth. So don't ever build your ministry on people. Then when God, when I believe on connect with what God called him with Jeremiah, that he said, don't look at their faces, just preach the word. So I settled my issue. You see, is that David was a man of war. This is what happened to him.
Psalm 55 verse 12, I read again. For it was not an enemy that reproached me, then I could have borne it. Neither was it he that hated me, that did magnify himself against me, then I would have hid myself from him.
Look at it. He said, if I know, it is my enemy. In other words, if you know somebody is your enemy, the enemy that show up himself is better than the one that doesn't show up himself. Hey, the one that show up himself, you know that at least he show himself that he's your enemy. One of the ones that did not tell you is killing you silently. Praise God. He said, it is not an enemy that reproaches you. It is a man of my equal. Read it. A man of what?
My equal.
Equal. Read it.
Verse 13. But it was thou, a man, my equal, my guide, and my acquaintance.
Look at it. He was his bodyguard. He was the right hand man. And we said, what is it? He said we went to the house of God together. Is that what he said the church are much than the one outside today? Mm. I said it for years. I've been saying this word. I've been going to repeat right from the beginning of the ministry. I said, if the church change, the city will change. If the church does not change, the city will not change. Because the city are looking at the people inside the church. They carry one image on Sunday. On Monday, another image. Praise Jesus. Read.
Verse 14. We took sweet counsel together.
Look at it. We took sweet counsel together.
And walked unto the house of God in company.
We took sweet counsel together. We pray together. We discuss together in church. Oh, Father, we thank you. We give you. We walk together into the house of God. My companion. The word. Read.
15. Let death seize upon them.
Look at the devil was saying, let death seize upon them.
And let them go down quick into hell.
Let them go down quick into hell.
For wickedness is in their dwellings.
Wickedness is in their dwelling.
And among them.
Among them. Every wicked power, every wicked person planning wickedness against you, against your children, they shall go down.
Amen.
They shall go down.
Amen.
They shall go down. 2 months ago. Why did your enemy rage? You see, you don't need to do anybody anything for them to rage. But if you have a purpose, you have God's testimony, you must rage, you can still. Praise Jesus. That's what I'm for. I don't do anybody anything. I'm repeating what told you the other last week here. I did not do anybody anything. You know, especially you people that is too educated. I don't do anybody anything. I don't think anybody will do me anything for my own. I don't do my own. Father. Praise Jesus. You don't need to do anybody anything. If you have a plan of God in your life, even you just make ordinary hair and you wear a nice shirt, you don't do somebody something. Praise Jesus. If you have a permanent job, you have done somebody something. In the person does not have. Praise Jesus. If you have this, my cap now, there are people that are just angry on you. Need. One, a pastor does a put on cap. I want to come here. Praise Jesus. You don't need to do anybody anything. Praise Jesus. Yes. Do you have God's destiny in your life? Yes. Do you speak the truth? Yes. Do you live by the truth? Yes. They will hate you. Mm-hmm. Read.
Verse 16. As for me, I will call upon God. The Lord shall save me.
Look at the God. Then he said, I will call upon God and the Lord will save me. Somebody, God will save me from my enemy. God will save me from my enemy. God will call upon God and God will save me. Then, well, that is David, a man of war, who fought all kinds of war in the Bible. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
People will say, oh, I do this one for me. If you do anything for me, don't fail. If you sing for me, you waste your time. You never receive one single blessing. If you are killing the church because of me, you just waste your destiny. If you come to clean church, say, Father, as I'm cleaning this church, I'm cleaning my life, the blessing of God will be to shower you. He said, I'll be cleaning this church for Pastor Rita. He has not even recognized me. And God will not recognize you. Heaven will not recognize you. Nobody will recognize you.
Amen.
Praise Jesus. God, they will say, I'm doing something for you. Who? Who is paying my salary? Is it not God that is paying my salary? God is, this church is not paying my salary. It's God that is paying my own. Why should I have to tell person to pay, to say, do it for me? Are you helping me? No. If you tell anybody here that says he's helping me, you are not helping devil. You don't help, you are not helping yourself. Praise Jesus. If you come with a clean heart to help God, God will help you in every situation. If you say you are coming to help me, oh God, devil will stop. God arrange for you that way. I'll begin to help you in the devil way. Read.
Verse 17. Evening and morning at noon, will I pray and cry aloud?
And then you say, evening, that is morning and evening, I will pray, I will cry aloud to God. I don't have time. Maybe I don't have time to be calling people here and there. And this is what you say. This is what you say. I don't have time. I don't have time. Well, yesterday, even as I said, somebody early in the morning called us after we pray again on Friday. God will just remove out the bed from your home. In the morning, I was sleeping. Somebody just come. I want to talk to Pastor Rita. Pastor Rita said, the person said, I don't negotiate with the devil.
Amen.
Let them confusion begin to enter their camp.
Amen.
Praise Jesus. Amen. Because that is the way they draw distraction. Praise God. Go ahead.
And he shall hear my voice. He has delivered my soul in peace.
He has delivered my soul in peace. God will deliver your soul in peace.
Amen.
God will, you want to deliver your soul in peace. Let me explain it for you. In the midst of turmoil, in the midst of confusion, you are at peace. Why the enemy is in confusion? Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You see, that's what my daughter will look at me. He says, sometimes I can't understand you, mommy. I say, what? He said, when I was going to try out with the court, the press will be coming my house. So we are sitting in front of my house. Eh? My daughter will say, I will train with Jesus. Then who knows I don't pass. This is what our Pastor Rita is a very big person.
Praise Jesus.
He said, you are not good. When I come home, I will just sit down, eat correct, put music and dance. Then the brother said, how do you do? He said, me myself, my heart is very good. I said, no. Who fight me is fighting Jehovah.
Yes.
It's not my battle. And I'm not going to go and fight myself in God. It is not that I will dress more. It is that I will eat correct food. It is that I will sleep well. Because I didn't owe anybody anything. The Bible said, hold over anything but to lock them. Praise Jesus. So he will say, mommy, anybody can give me the kind of heart. See, it's only through the word of God. When you begin to put the word of God in your heart becomes strong in the Lord. Where the devil is running up and down, he said the devil is like what? He is not a lion. Look at that scripture. The devil is not a lion. He is like. He wants to imitate. Praise it. That's somebody. My faith is bigger than my fear.
My faith is bigger than my fear.
That is what someone three times. My faith is bigger than my fear.
My faith is bigger than my fear. My faith is bigger than my fear. My faith is bigger than my fear.
See, many people let their fear overrule their faith. And God said those kind of people cannot receive anything from God. But God said, I will deliver you. Okay. On my way. Somebody talks something. We can't deliver you. No. Stand still. God said, tell the children of Israel. He said, stand still. You will see the salvation of the Lord today. The Jews that you see before, you shall see them no more. The enemy drowned in the Red Sea with your eyes. Praise Jesus. Read the 20.
He had delivered my soul in peace from the battle that was against me.
By the battle that was against me.
For there were many with me.
Look at it. There were many with me. Many. Praise Jesus. Go ahead.
God shall hear and afflict them, even he that abided of old.
Look at the elders that are against you. God will afflict them with different sickness.
Yeah.
You will not even know. Yeah. Not because somebody will get dressed, doesn't mean it's normal. Yeah. Praise Jesus.
Yeah.
I think one said what he said. We have seen a devil in suit and come to church and begin to challenge God. Praise Jesus. He said that when the power of God found that sickness, we carry sickness and go. There are people who have challenged God, they are carrying sickness around. Praise Jesus. Go ahead. Then he said, let them be afflicted. Sickness. Read.
Because they have no changes. Therefore they fear not God.
There are people, wicked people who will never change. They are meant for destruction. There are some that will change. There are some that will not change. That does not bother you. Oh, it's left for God to handle.
Praise God. Go ahead. Verse 20. He had put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him. He had broken his covenant.
You see, when people break their covenant, just leave them alone. You see, people don't know what is called covenant. Holy communion will take every all night here. What we do all night? We take Holy communion. People don't know the signification of Holy communion. They only just put it like your daily bread. That is an oath in the spirit. Covenant. You have entered a covenant with the person. And together. Then you go back and start destroying the person. And start saying, you are not in your own covenant. You are not destroying your own life. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because they don't know what is God covenant. They just go to, you see, there are a bunch of people. I said something to a person yesterday when I was explaining to a man here, Margaret Osborne. I said, we have Christian, Europe Christian. You don't call Europe Christian. They only start to go to church in Europe. They don't understand what is called relationship with God. They don't understand what is called Christianity. And they also have some that have bad relations with God. Because of the environment that they are find themselves, they become confused. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. So then they begin to commonize the word of God. Please take off that baby. They begin to commonize the word of God. Take off that baby, please. A lot of people are watching this program. Praise the body. Enemies are no enemies. They are watching. God is in YouTube. Is there. Praise God. It's live internet all over the world. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. So, verse 20, read.
Verse 20, I repeat. He had put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him. He had broken his covenant.
He has broken it. When somebody break their covenant, just leave them alone. Covenant is a very thing. Covenant is not a promise. Look at, you have to define covenant. Covenant is not a promise. Covenant is different. Covenant is an agreement between two people. Agreement between two people. If you break it, there's a law of the spirit. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can we go to Amos quickly? Amos, I pray I finish this message today. Why? Amos
5. Amos chapter 5, from verse
17 to 20, quickly.
17 to 20. And in all vineyards shall be wailing, for I will pass through thee again, saith the Lord. Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord. To what end is it for you? The day of the Lord is darkness and not light, as if a man did flee from a lion, and a bear met him, or went into the house, and laid his hand on the wall, and a serpent bit him. Shall not the day of the Lord be darkness and not light, even every dark and no brightness in it?
The day of the Lord is going to be very interesting, praise God. The many people does not understand. They only can only Sunday they will go. But the day of the Lord is just at door knocking. Jesus is coming very soon. Praise Jesus. That's why who want to continue to do wickedness, let me continue to do wickedness. Who want to continue to be doing evil, let me continue to be doing evil. So you want to identify. Look at the book of Deuteronomy 27, verse 24, quickly. I want to go to the main Bible verse for this thing. Verse 24 alone.
Cursed be he that smiteth his neighbor secretly.
Look at it. Look at that one. How do you smite people secretly? No, I said, cursed be who that smiteth his neighbor secretly. How do we smite people? By mouth. Our mouth. You will see people today in church. They will just laugh at you, smile at you. Oh, yeah, do you like me? They say, Pastor Richard, I love you. You're my mama. Mommy, 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 Pastor, Pastor, Pastor. You see, you need God to give you discernment. If they are pastoring you or they are mocking you, you have to go through the soul and pierce and find the intention of the heart. He said, a man of the spirit searching the things of the spirit. Compare spiritual thing to spiritual. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Now sometimes people will just be calling mommy and froze. That's me. Praise Jesus. Now God will deserve, praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. You have to open your eyes to know who is killing you. Some of them are vomiting you into the grave. Some are pastoring you into the confusion. So you have to be able to jump. I reject it in Jesus' name. I reject it in Jesus' name. I reject it in Jesus' name. You know what's here saying? The Bible says, not those that come, my father shall go into the kingdom of heaven. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Snake, we call him money. Witches, we call him money. Every kind of people things, we call him money. Which one will you answer? Praise Jesus. Your friend, you will meet your friend time. Your friend don't plan for you to kill you. When you meet your friend, he say, brother, how is he? How are you? Give me five. When you give my friend, why you don't plan to kill him? He was saying, let us go to somebody. But as he have just put you in the cold room and discussed you yesterday night, and you are drinking the same beer with him. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's go to Ezekiel quickly. Ezekiel quickly. Before I go to Ezekiel, this is 101 first. See what God said we do to those kind of people. Don't have a plan for those kind of people. If you know how to pray, go have a plan for them. Praise. If you have them as a friend, go have a plan for them. If you have them as a company member, go have a plan for them. If you have them as a church member, go also have a plan for them. But as a church member, look at God, what speak about it. I'll speak about it. Read.
I must go one verse.
Praise Jesus. Verse 5.
Whoso briefly slandereth his neighbor.
Look at that one. Hear attention.
Him will I cut off. Him that had a high look. And
you know, God said, anyone that slandered his neighbor at the back. God said, he will cut it off from the congregation of God. Yes. You slander, for example, Rapport come to church. He just said, when he go, I said, no matter how you slander Rapport, that kill the bomb. You see, God is another gossip. They are gossip. God is a thing of blessing. People are even looking. They are carrying spear to go and pass spear to carry the king. They can't have it. Praise Jesus. I said, hey, that's not the king. I don't know why they just not the king. I don't know why they bomb, 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 bomb. Can you be God?
No.
Now your king can break that down. People don't go to occult kingdom, witchcraft kingdom, and they don't go to family kingdom, they don't get. Even some people, they go up to the doctor say, you pray, don't die. You know the function. God will produce and give people that. So I was just going to finish. Remember, I called them, hey, Shalom! Congratulations! Oh, God bless you. Praise Jesus. God said those kind of people shall be cut off in the church. They shall be cut off. They shall be cut off. Praise Jesus. That is when I see some kind of gossip, that's it. I begin to cut them. Begin to cut them. Cut. Then suddenly the angel of God will show up. I start to swing with the church. We broom in the spirit realm. When the broom don't go, you don't say shaking, one start. Praise Jesus. Read from Matthew 18:18 quickly. I want to show you something. So you understand what is called spiritual. Many people are not going to the one is called spiritual laws. I want to read it from Amplifier also. Somebody will read from Amplifier. I read it from King James. Read it from King James. I want to see what is called spiritual law. People don't know. There's a law that rules with you. I mean, if you are driving, you beat the traffic light. What will happen? They find you. You will pay. I was driving through Willis. That road that told through Willis. I don't even know that the 30 they put on that place. That was last year. I will speed. Somebody said it was the daughter wanted to jump from ups here. So with that speed, I was just, I didn't know police were there, they just, pack. As I packed like this, they say, 45. So we are not going to give you 2,500. That 2,500, I cry. You see, I just broke, it would have helped somebody in my orphanage home. Praise Jesus. But at the end, I said, God, please, I will still meet this kid. I said, can you just give me the ticket and let me go, time is going. I go there, everybody were begging the girl to come down. So go and walk to there. Then I said, I was talking sweet. Talk. Finally, come down. Mm-hmm. Then I said, Father, thank you for this one today. You passed 2,500. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Go read.
Matthew 18, verse 18.
To 19.
Truly I tell you, whatever you forbid and declare to be improper and unlawful on earth must be what is already forbidden in heaven.
Look at it. There are so many things we are accepting, which God did not want you to accept. But he said, whatever you forbid here on earth, improper, heaven will forbid it. Whatever you accepted, heaven will accept it. You accepted it. So you take it. Praise God. So most of the time, what we are fighting God say, God, I don't know why you like this. God say, you are the one that permitted it. Praise Jesus. If you're like a man who will go and marry a wicked woman, if a woman you see on the corner, you don't know the family, you don't know where you come from, or a man, you don't know where the family come from, you don't know where they come from, you just marry the man, don't tell anybody, don't tell your family, you don't marry snake, you don't marry spirit. Say, God does these people. Later, the man don't pray. Trouble. Say, now you choose and now praise God. Deal with what you choose. Praise Jesus. Deal with what you choose. You see, whatever you pack into your head is permitted. You go, angel will sign it. God will sign it. Look at verse 19.
Again, I tell you, if two of you on earth agree,
two people, you don't need 20 million people to agree with you. Only two people agree with you on earth. That's why they say any family that pray together, they live together. Marriage, husband and wife, I advise you. When you pray together, no power can break you. Last week, I just get into my 25 years new ring again. Praise Jesus. 25 years. So you have to, if you pray together, no power can break you, praise Jesus. They will try. They will not succeed. Read.
Verse 19. Again, I tell you, if two of you on earth agree about any, whatever they whatever they may ask, it may be done
for them in heaven. Any two people agree on this side, sincerity, not fake. That's why I don't quickly agree to anybody. Either my children, my husband. Any people in the few, pretty few. Because if I say I agree, let me agree with Brantine. If I'm Brantine, I want to agree with you that I want to buy a new latest plane. If I don't tell you I want to buy a plane, the eye will tell you me look. The first of all, you feel it already is used. I remember, you know my bag of how much you feel, what be the play? If you don't nullify my prayer. Oh God, let's just say, okay, Pastor, I agree with you. You can use Pastor face. You don't know who they get Pastor face. You don't see Pastor face. People, they say, Pastor, yes, they bring it, oh, Pastor, I'll be thinking to agree with you for now. Yeah, Pastor, without for you, say, Pastor. Apparently praying for the plane, he is praying. You will never get it. It cannot be possible. Why not be sweating? Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. No. So that is why you have to go into the spirit of know who is agreeing with you. And who is not agreeing with you. Amos 3:3 says something. Read. Look at what Amos said. It's not everybody that is agreeing with you. Praise Jesus. That's why a marriage where a man or a woman go to outside to be telling people they are married, the husband and everywhere, the husband is narrating, the wife is narrating to every people in the town. No, that marriage is bound to be destroyed. Praise Jesus. I said after next week, because we have a guest speaker. Fire coming next week from London. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. So after next week, I will start marriage message. Read.
Amos 3:3, I read from Amplified. Do two walk together except they make an appointment and have agreed?
Agree! Unless they agree. Let me tell you an example. Since a Veronica will come to meet me, say, Pastor, I want you to agree with me. I want to buy a house. Or I want to marry a new husband. Or I want to buy a new plot. And so the first, Veronica, come. You will have it in Jesus' name. What I have is give you, go make it to pass. I will agree with Veronica. Veronica will go. When Veronica goes, he will go and meet this my sister. This my sister will bring my story. Say, Pastor, it's too much. That my one lie, it's too much. Veronica said, don't bother, I'm a very stupid woman. You never know how to be. He said, he will never receive anything. You can be inside this church for 30 years. Because two of us were not in agreement. Even when I pray, general prayer, other people will receive, they can't receive. Why? Because we are not in agreement. They are just warm each other inside the church. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. It's not going to agree. You agree with me. You want this. I also agree with you. Oh, Father, I bless you. You receive. Praise Jesus. So that's how I walk. Let us go to the final Bible verse quickly. Ezekiel 14, quickly. Ezekiel 14. Read. Read from verse 1 quickly.
Then came certain of the elders of Israel unto me, and sat before me. And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, verse 3, Son of man, these men have set up their idols in their heart.
You see, you are coming to a pastor, you are coming to God, you are putting an idol in your heart. It's like somebody that wants to marry. He will say, oh, Pastor, I want to marry. I have three women. And the three women, you are sleeping with them. What is the point telling God again? Don't use your honor.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah. Say, Pastor, pray for me. You are already speaking. There's no God that will interfere for this kind of matter. Because you have already set an idol of fornication in your heart. Praise Jesus. It's only a stupid pastor who does not understand spiritual that will be fine. You know, say this pastor of this last day, if they don't open their eyes, they will be sweating. Many things will be going on. They don't even know what they are praying for. Read it.
Son of man, these men have set up their idols in their heart and put a stumbling block of their iniquity before their face.
Look at it, they put a stumbling block of iniquity before their face. What is their face? They come, they carry a pretend face. Pastor pray now, and just one. Three women, sleeping with the three. The pastor will see the prayer, which one? There's one story Oruboya told me, which is very interesting. So a man brought a list of five women. Say, Pastor, pray over these five women. So the pastor said, I used to say, yes, I had to test all of them to know. Which one is really good inside? He said, as I say, leave my office. Leave my office. Leave the office. He now went to a branch. Pastor who was not disciplined. The brother pastor said, okay, I'm not going to, which one did you really like inside? The brother pastor was using wisdom, he was using IQ for him. He said, this one get car. This one don't be, has not been done finished. Oh God. Many people go so far when we're. This one don't get anything. We are not responsible for their responsibility. He made all of that to the pastor. The pastor said, okay, go. I will pray. When he come after 3 days, the pastor said, you know that one where you get car? Let me be your wife. Carry that one, go, tan, 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 tan. You know, it takes many people to plan marriage. But after the marriage is finished, they told them to go to stay with it. Tan, 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 tan. Not that way, yes, they find where way. You know when you think about anything that day? Everything becomes a suit. You see, and that white dress is going to suit. With a trap, you see? With a trap. With a trap, you call it that altar. Pastor don't marry, come marry you. When you marry the finish, after the day, I fight bust out. The man battered the lady face. As battered the lady face, that lady every day too much for. They don't even really well. After 2 months, now the man, the lady, the battered, then he come throw the man penis. The man come die. They have to inform a quarter. I said, and the man went me. When you come with me. So that they were seeing all or Jobaru. Then it is what happened. Then they contested that the pastor, the friend contested that the other pastor was the brother, and I tell him, that the one with the haircut. I think the man was very good. You know, many people have ended up in their grave for marrying wrong people. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah, my brother, quickly.
Should I be inquired of at all by them? Therefore speak unto them and say unto them, thus saith the Lord God, every man of the house of Israel that setteth up his idol in his heart and putteth the stumbling block of his iniquity before his face and cometh to the prophet, I the Lord will answer him that cometh according to the multitude of his idols.
Okay. God said, if you have an idol, you are, what is the word, that word, the meaning of that word? Iniquity. You see, you continue to repeat. He says, it's a stumbling block. So when you are going to acquire from the prophet, God will put a lying spirit in the mouth of the prophet. The prophet will tell you, say, oh, now I tell that again, that man. The prophet will say, this is the one where that one is going to what God is supposed to choose for you. You will say, that man of God is a very powerful man of God. Because you have carried your iniquity, God will put a lying spirit in the mouth of the prophet. The prophet will not speak to the wrong one. Praise Jesus. Because you have come with idol. You see, many people look at the idol in Africa like the wicked. The one in our heart is more dangerous. Praise God. Go ahead.
Verse 4, yes, I read again. Therefore speak unto them and say unto them, thus saith the Lord God, every man of the house of Israel that setteth up his idols in his heart and putteth the stumbling block of his iniquity before his face, and comment to the prophet, I the Lord will answer him that cometh according to the multitude of his idols. Verse 5. That I may take the house of Israel in their own heart, because they are all estranged from me through their idols. Therefore, say unto the house of Israel, thus saith the Lord God, repent and turn yourselves from
your idols. Tell somebody repent. Tell somebody in your neighbor, tell somebody repent. Say three times, repent. Repent. Because you don't do one thing. Okay, let me tell you. All the people that they are still doing is all your kind of sin and sin. What are still guilty for all these many years? Some people, because of their sins, they can't get old. Their nature become over. Praise Jesus. They will lose their beauty because of sin. They lost their nature because of sin. Praise Jesus. That's why they repent again.
Amen.
Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Go ahead.
And turn away your faces from all your abominations.
Look at that. What says that? Abomination. Read it.
For every one of the house of Israel, or of the stranger that sojourned in Israel, which separated himself from me and set up his idols in his heart.
You separate yourself from God and set an idol. Resurrection ministry. Let's not be drink. Let's not be. What is your feet do now? This story tired me. Drink, I don't feel drink. Who am I not feel carry? Praise Jesus. What did you want to do for Sweden? I don't feel drink alcohol. I don't feel carry a woman. What am I going to do? It's everything has a vacation. Praise God. Hallelujah. I don't feel carry a man. I don't feel sleep with any man. I need to get a whole husband for us. Many of you will remember me many. You won't remember me when the time comes. You remember me.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. I was telling my husband yesterday. I said, it takes so many people to leave this church, to go to another church, go to another for many years, many years. Then they won't remember me because we're not married to us, but I don't know one who should go to. And people that are married to us, but they understand that the first husband was even better than the one they leave. The one they have been with.
Praise Jesus.
He said, my hands are not good, they're evil. From fry pan. So it will take so many people to leave the church. They will go to at least 10 churches. Then they will come and find out the truth later. I just say, this thing Pastor Rita talking. The wages of sin is death. And if we will take sickness, we'll go to wake up. Ace. Hardship, poverty, frustration for people to get it. They will get it.
Praise Jesus.
Try hanging under the green grass. And they got that on Sunday. Hey, on Monday, you'll be snake outside. It's hard. Don't deceive yourself. We don't have the time to deceive ourselves anymore. Let us be plain. And if nobody in this reading will tell anybody the truth, I, Pastor Rita, must tell you the truth. You can't do me fucking.
Amen.
Nothing. The worst they can do is you carry me to COVID. As you carry me to COVID, Holy Ghost will consume all of them.
Amen.
Don't carry me. They don't carry me to even COVID, but they don't die for me. They die for me now. They time for me, they come and house. They say, we don't hire for you. That you don't have this country. Other pastor, they will be your name pastor in this country. I said, no. Meanwhile, they leave Africa, I'm going to open church for a year. 25, I leave Africa since 25 years. I never expected I would stay in Sweden for 10. When I came to Sweden, I said, my mother told me, he said, I've been in Sweden for 10 years. I said, what are you doing? That time was just my 10 years. So I said, it's crazy. A black man go there for Europe for 10 years. I said, it's madness. I don't come to the five now.
Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus.
So you have to understand, before God carried me from Africa, I come open church for this demonic city. I need business, praise God. And I am determined. That's why I am determined.
I am determined.
Praise Jesus. Read my brother to 11.
Verse 7. And put there the stumbling block of his iniquity before his face. And come to a prophet to inquire of him concerning me. I, the Lord, will answer him by myself. And I will set my face against that man. And will make him a sign and a proverb.
Look at it. I will make him a sign and what? And a proverb. I will tell you about how long that was last year. I met a man that was, normally if I drive to a certain place, I will park my car. If I want to meet somebody or I'm walking somewhere, about if I'm going on the street and I meet anybody, I will use that opportunity to just minister to the person. I'll give him a track or I'll just talk to the person. There was one man, that morning, like that was last year, early January last year, we were under fasting. I was going to work, they called me for work and I should come and talk to one woman. So I was coming from that place. I was walking, I packed myself in a very long place that is industrial gutter for near cemetery. Then, but never I packed my car. I was walking, going to that rehab there to talk to the woman. And I met one man, one black man. I was telling him, I said, Jesus loves you so much. I want to talk about Jesus Christ to you. He said, oh, Pastor, don't tell me. I know you're black. I'm not interested. I go to church. I said, forget about church. I'm not talking about church. People go to church. So they will tell people, they say they go to church. Which church? Which church? You call this place a church? This is not a church. Praise God. You are a church. I'm a church. You are a church. I'm a church. Church means to become the temple of heaven. Praise God. No. I'm not interested. I'm interested. You go. I just walk out. Praise God. As enough, you did what I did. I just my leg and look at him. That's what the scripture told to me. Suddenly, this January we are so doing for this God. God wants to arrange something. Everything you do is an arrangement in the spirit. But sometimes in the same time we arrange it, God was already. January, I was in Triangle. I was just going to Abbas from Elian there. So even that was this, same week I meet the brother. He was in the wheelchair. I was passing. He was Pastor Rita. I told him. I said, oh, why? He said, I'm there, brother. I said, you and you. He said, please put me in prayer. They'll be stroke from here. Put me in prayer. I'm just coming from the hospital now. Please put me in prayer. I froze there. I don't know what to tell him. First of all, my mouth was not me to pick my wife because now you would reject the word of God that day. Now you are calling me Pastor Rita to pray for you. I could not do that. I said, God, may God have mercy on you. I will put you in prayer because I already let you be a mouth. You see, the same God, it becomes a reproach, signs for God to see that if you reject God's word, God say, I will reject you. If you reject God's word, God can reject anybody who rejects his word. Praise Jesus. Read the finish.
And I will cut him off from the midst of my people.
God said, I will cut him off from the midst of what? My people.
And ye shall know that I am the Lord.
You shall know that I am the Lord.
And if the prophet be deceived when he has spoken a thing, I, the Lord, have deceived that prophet.
Look at God said he will deceive the prophet. Because he don't want to speak the truth. You know, we are today, we pastor, we try to. So we got this. So far that we cannot lose a member. Me, I'm not in category of knowledge. Why I would rather lose 100 members instead of 1. Praise God. Hallelujah. Maybe because maybe I'm not receiving salary, I don't even care. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. If you say you are the biggest tithe in the world, in this church, if you are coming, God will replace with 12 people more than you. You are, it becomes like you are not. Praise Jesus. If you come out to honor you, God will honor you. If you come out to elevate you, God will elevate you. If you want to say that without you, you are not, God will say, you are with you. I can do with millions to replace you. Praise Jesus. That is the God we serve. That is the God we serve. That is why if people tell you, I don't bother you. I have never gone to any church member house and say, brother, we are not be able to pay church rent. Please, can we contribute? No! I thank God, if you call me, you will pay your fees. I need to thank God this way. I don't use hunger to return ministry. Praise God. And all the people God really called from the ministry, they were already in, someone is ready. Before God begin to call them. Praise Jesus. Can we stand on our feet? Don't move around with snakes. When you pray this prayer, you begin to see, God will begin to show you some many things. Certain people, you begin to ask, your eyes begin to open. To see this, if you pray from sincerely from your heart, Brian Timmy said, can you read one Bible verse before we start? Job 24, verse 14 to 16, before we start the prayer. Father, we thank you. We give you the glory and the honor. We exalt your holy name. You are magnified. You are glorified. Ancient of days, everlasting Father. Thank you, Jesus.
Job chapter 24, from 24 to 25.
No, 14 to 16. Chapter 24, 14 to 16.
14 to 16, I read. In the dark, they dig through houses, which they have marked for themselves in the daytime. They know not the light, for the morning is to them even as the shadow of death. Mm. If one know them, they are in the terrors of the shadow of death.
Amen. Dark houses. You take the first prayer like this, Father, we just thank you. We give you the glory and the honor in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for your word that will go out and complete the purpose we send in this hour. Father, according to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, verse 20, we hasten your word to perform in this afternoon. Thank you, Father. Arrow of God.
Arrow of God.
Arrow of God.
Arrow of God.
Look at the enemy.
Look at the enemy.
Hiding behind.
Hiding behind.
Spiritual mask.
Spiritual mask.
To fight me.
To fight me.
To fight destruction.
To fight destruction.
I sponsor me in the name of Jesus. Every spiritual mask, I need any spiritual mask to fight me. To fight my children, to fight destruction. Expose them by fire of the Holy Ghost. Let the arrow of God expose them by fire. Locate wherever they are in the aquatic kingdom, the witchcraft kingdom, the marine kingdom. In my father's house, in my mother's house. In my other family's house, in the city of Mammon. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You masquerading enemy.
You masquerading enemy.
You masquerading enemy.
You masquerading enemy.
Be exposed and be disgraced. Every masquerading enemy in my life. In my children's life, in this shop. Be exposed and be disgraced. Be exposed and be disgraced. Be exposed. Mighty name we pray. Yes, one thing you know, anybody that has a vision, that have a goal, is not being looking at. Here is going to pay attention. There are two actors running. And they are running, one to take the call. The other one, if you look back, you can miss your aim. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You tell this prayer. You masquerading giant.
You masquerading giant.
Receive divine thunder.
Receive divine thunder.
And disclose your identity.
And disclose your identity.